But the way that they played in the opener, I think a lot of people are wondering what kind of Browns team are we going to see tonight?
Very interesting question. We'll find out tonight. The weekend starts today. Is brought to you by DraftKings, America's top-rated daily fantasy app. So, all right, Key, I mean, Jake sort of answered it in his opinion, but from your opinion, having played the game, it is just week two, but what is the pressure on the Browns tonight?
Oh, it's a lot of pressure. It's heavy pressure. You go 0-2, just like Jake said, people, it's gonna get ugly in Cleveland at 0-2, given the fact that they got everything aligned for them from a talent standpoint. I don't need to go through every single player, but just on the defensive side of the ball, Denzel Ward's over there, Myles Garrett's over there. Offensively, you got OBJ, you got Chubb, you got Kareem Hunt, they just paid a little bit of money to, and then you got Baker Mayfield. I mean, so when you look at new head coach Kevin Stefanski coming over from Minnesota, you expected for this offense to look much different than it did in week one. Put week one behind. Cincinnati is not a juggernaut in the NFL. Like, you shouldn't be.
No, they're not.
Like, based on your talent and where you're at, you shouldn't be dropping one to Cincinnati at home. You just shouldn't be. And I think that they understand that. They know that there's pressure. Eyeballs are watching. No negative things were coming out of camp this year about the Cleveland Browns because it was quiet. It was, shh, don't say anything. Let's just go about our business. And so we expected for them to come out and play much better than they did against Baltimore last week, and it didn't happen. Now you have a chance to erase that performance and put something on film that we all look to and go, okay, this looks like the team that we think they can be to try to make a run into the playoffs, or at least give us some sort of hope that you can put a plus 500 season together.
Mm-hmm. I'm thinking it's a must-win for this team. And I'm not saying that everything will, you know, go crazy if they don't win, but the amount of pressure that will be on this team afterwards and then these storylines will continue to fester. Baker Mayfield, OBJ, can they ever get on the same page if he doesn't get targeted as much? I think there has to be a lot more pressure, too, Key, on Kevin Stefanski. Baker Mayfield is not a Russell Wilson-type quarterback. Don't drop him back into the pocket. Get him involved in more play action. I mean, Chubb and Kareem Hunt, these guys rush for 132 yards against the Ravens. Get him in action that keeps him moving. That's when this team is going to be at their best.
Well, the thing about Kevin Stefanski is when you go back and you look at Minnesota, what he was able to do with Kirk Cousins long-term for the years that Kirk has been there underneath him, it was pretty impressive, right? It was better than what you expected. He has some of the same tools with Landry and OBJ. He also has the tight end now, Cooper. He also has the running game.
Yeah, Hooper.
Hooper. He also has the running game, and they have a defense. So I think that they'll get in sync. This is the second time around. They can go back and look at the film and see the things that they made the mistakes on, make those corrections. On a short week, come out, execute. I want to see execution and flawless. I don't want to see any hiccups. I don't want to see any off penalties, false starts, looking like they're out of sync. I want to see smooth. Even if they lost the game, I want to see smooth, right? I want to see something. Mm. That's what they got to show me. They got to show me that. If they show me that, then I'm like, okay. If they go 0-2, though, and it's all herky-jerky, it's going to be problematic.
Even if they are smooth, think about what the storylines start on Friday. You have a rookie quarterback that gets the best of Baker Mayfield, right? You have all these pieces, and then the questions continue to loom. Like, how do you have all these offensive weapons and you can't get the job done? I mean, granted, a lot depends on the way they lost, but the stories will only compound if they lose. I don't think you can lose this game, not to a rookie quarterback.
They can't lose, but if they do, as long as something positive comes out of it, I mean, the game could be 21-21 late in the fourth quarter, and it could be a 50-yard field goal, and they lose the game.
I just don't see us extracting positives out of a loss for the Browns.
No,
right,
you maybe not from a media standpoint, but I'm talking internally from a team standpoint. That's most important. They can't worry about us. They just can't. They've got to concentrate on getting their team going in the right direction. Sitting around worrying about what the media going to say, the media is going to find something positive or negative. So you can't worry about that when you're dealing with a team aspect.
That's a great point. We'll talk more about it with Damian Woody. He'll join us on the Shell Pennzoil Performance Line at 7:15. What do you got?
I was going to say very quickly, that's one thing for us to say. It's another thing to go back to when we were both players and you're in the locker room And it may not affect Keyshawn Johnson, but it could affect a Baker Mayfield. It could affect, you know, OBJ.
Well, Baker Mayfield and OBJ better get their head out the sand.
I know, but not everybody's built psychologically the way that you're built.
They better get built that way.
And we know how it is. You know, post-game, if you're in a locker room, having all the press ask you all these questions, you go back home to your respective families or your agents, people are saying things that you need to do. If you're in a contract year, whatever it is, all these things start to fester. I don't care what anybody says. Not everybody's built as strong psychologically as Keyshawn Johnson.
No, that's true, though, Jay. But what I'm saying, though, is you have to take care the internal part. The noise outside is going to be there. But you cannot satisfy fans when you're trying to get things corrected internally. They have to get things corrected. The offensive's got to move and put points on the board. Baker Mayfield has got to play better. He can't worry about throwing an interception in, well, they won't be booing because nobody will be in the stands, but he can't worry about somebody in a headline saying, Baker does it again, another pick. You cannot worry about those things. You've got to take care of that locker room, all 53 of those guys. That's who you are responsible for, and that's what you have to do. Once you start worrying about us, we got you. You cooked at that point.
I would be remiss if I didn't say we are in the midst of a pandemic. People are isolated. What do people check all day, every day?
Their phones.
Scroll. That's all I'm saying. So it's one thing to say, hey, don't listen to it. But when it's in front of your face every day, people are chattering, friends are saying things to you. You can't help it.
Don't listen to Jay Will, y'all.
I'm not saying to listen to it. I wouldn't try to listen to it.
OBJ, listen to Jay Will. Don't check your phone. Don't check your phone, Baker. Just play football.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.